Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about the new Psycopg driver for Python. We're also going to talk about pipeline mode in Psycopg and how it works. First of all, I want to give a quick shout out to Daniele, who has been maintaining Psycopg and has started the new Psycopg 3 project that aims to bring a modern Postgres driver to Python. They've recently released the Psycopg 3.1 release. There are a couple of interesting announcements in here, including things like supporting copper HTTP and better cursor support, but I want to focus today on pipeline mode. Pipeline mode is a contribution to Psycopg by Denis from the Libpq team. In this blog post, he describes why pipeline mode matters, the performance improvements it brings, and how you can use it in Python. If you are not familiar with pipeline mode in Postgres, we talked about this in 5 Minutes of Postgres a couple of weeks ago, and really the main difference between using pipeline mode and regular query execution is that pipeline mode will send multiple queries to the server without having to wait for results. The main benefit is that you're saving on network latency, which if you're in the cloud and maybe you're talking across availability zones, network latency quickly adds up. If you have a really fast query, that query itself might execute under 1 millisecond, but the network latency could be as much as 2 or 3 milliseconds. In Psycopg, with these recent changes, we simply have to call connection.pipeline, and then things that are done inside this block here will actually run in pipeline mode instead of running as regular queries. The example we have here is using a table and using inserts. Pipeline mode isn't limited to doing writes. You can also use it with reads, but oftentimes writes are going to be more independent. You can't say, send this query, and then when I have the result, do this other thing. The idea behind pipeline mode is that you have independent statements. Here, the example we take for each value that gets inserted, we take the factorial. If you had all the data already available, you should just do a multi-row insert. That's going to be much more efficient. But sometimes you have data that you're calculating as you're inserting, and so having to calculate everything up front would be quite expensive. You want to have that step-by-step process that pipeline mode enables. In this example program, there are two modes. There's the pipeline mode and the regular mode. And in both cases, we're creating a factorial of a certain number, and then we're executing an insert statement into the database. Before we jump into how that compares performance-wise, a quick note on the background of how this works. We can look at the actual communication between a client and a server using the trace functionality in Libpq. And Libpq is the underlying C library that most drivers in Postgres, including Psycopg, use to talk to the database. There's PQtrace function, that's a C function, that Psycopg can use when you enable tracing. It will give you an output like this. And in this output, you'll see the notion of F, meaning front-end, meaning the client, and B, meaning back-end or the server. For example, here in this case, is a regular query protocol interaction without pipelining. In this case, the front-end says sync, then it waits for the server to respond, and then the client sends additional data. The idea is you have this challenge response interaction between the front end and the back end. And in Psycopg, we can just use the trace function to enable this tracing, and then we can compare how this output looks like between pipelining and regular runs. Without pipelining, we have a parse message first that parses the query without actual values. You then have a sync message, then the server tells you, yep, I parsed this query, I'm ready for your data. Then you send the server this bind message, and you tell the server to execute that data. Server says, okay, got it. There's no result to be returned because it's just a simple insert, and then tell you command complete, I executed this command. And then you send the next insert statement, the next data. As you can see, there's a lot of waiting for the server to return data back to the client. And this obviously adds up. If we have pipeline mode, this looks much more efficient. We have the same messages pretty much, but then instead of doing all the sync and all this waiting, we do parse, and then right away we do a bind, and then we execute, and we do another bind, and we execute, and we keep doing that. Now, at some point, the server is going to say, oh, my output buffers are busy. I need to start returning you some data, even though you didn't wait for it. The server will start returning you data and tell you command complete. And so you could actually work with these results. What Denis observed was that even on localhost, even if there is no network latency, just the inter-process overhead added up enough that this made 2x difference, like twice as fast, when running it with pipelining. And you can imagine that for fast queries, this could be a 10x difference in the cloud. It's a huge difference for some workloads. As Denis notes here, this required months of work and a lot of thinking and testing. I'm really thankful that folks are out there working on these hard problems for Postgres client drivers so that ultimately we can have faster applications. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.